Lakewood is not really a suburb anymore. It's a particular kind of urban place that looks suburban superficially, but which is netted fully into an urban fabric.
Hi, I'm Matt Welch for Reason TV, and I'm here today with the eminent Southern California writer, thinker, historian, DJ Waldie, famously of Holy Land, the acclaimed book that he wrote about the city of Lakewood, where we're sitting right now. DJ, thank you very much
for joining us today. Very kind words.
Most people know you through Holy Land or through your blogging at KCET and writing in the LA Times and elsewhere, but you have also been for decades working for the city of Lakewood, where I once worked briefly as a teenager. Lakewood is a contract city, one of the first or one of the few contract cities out there. Can you tell us a little bit about the history of that concept, how it has applied to the development of Lakewood, and how Lakewood is different than cities around it?
Well, interestingly enough, Lakewood was the very first city in the nation to contract for most of its municipal services from other sources. Initially, that other source was the County of Los Angeles, but in the decades following 1954, when Lakewood incorporated, we branched out to provide services under contract with the county, like our sheriff's department, services with private industry, like trash collection and street sweeping, services with other public entities, other consortia. For example, our animal control service is done by a consortium of cities that banded together to provide animal control services. And some services are conducted in-house, like the one you used to work for, which is our park department, which originally was a standalone special district, but in 1957 was folded into the city of Lakewood as our recreation department. Now, in 54, this was a radically different idea. No city in America had incorporated on that basis. But in the years following, the success of Lakewood led to lots of incorporations of cities that are like Lakewood in contracting for all or most of their municipal services. So there are about 40 cities in LA County that are contract cities, and there are about 140 cities in the state of California, of about the 480 cities there are also contract cities, and there's some unknown number, because we don't track every detail of this, some unknown number of contract cities around the nation.
And how has that affected the development of the city, its political culture or its governance culture, or just the results compared to other places around?
I mean, the obvious one is that we're a city of about 83,000 persons, about 9.5 square miles. I mean, kind of roughly the same size as Santa Monica, for example, but our workforce is tiny by comparison. We only have about 170 city employees. Our city's staff at City Hall is very small.
Do you know Santa Monica's or similar cities?
Well, because they have their own police department, they have a much larger workforce in the several hundreds of employees. So contracting allowed us to be very lean in terms of our overhead and to be very flexible, because we can contract with one entity when it's providing the best kind of service and then change our minds and contract with someone else in the future some other way. But very difficult to change the dynamics of a city service provision model if you have regular full-time benefited unionized employees who are providing those services.
And how has Lakewood come through, you know, the recent long-standing at this point unpleasantness in California in terms of local governments, the state government, and et cetera?
Well, we've been very lucky for a long time, but small cities like Lakewood can't be lucky always or forever. And so we're suffering, like other cities are, through a very difficult economic period with diminished sales at our major shopping mall, with families living from paycheck to paycheck, with an unfortunate number of foreclosed properties. The saving grace for Lakewood in the face of all of that has been a very conservatively run city, specifically a city that's pinched every penny it can for decades and decades.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but Lakewood and the sort of the Long Beach area that we're in was basically the Levittown of the West Coast. How many thousands of houses were built in how few days?
Empty farmland in 1949, purchased by three developers. Construction began in late 1949. 17,500 houses built in less than 3 years. So we had an instant city in the form of Lakewood, but of course it wasn't actually a city. It was unincorporated county territory. It took political will on the part of residents in the years following the completion of the building of the houses to turn this immense tract of residential suburban Los Angeles into a real city. And in 1954, Lakewood became a city through that contract plan we discussed earlier.
Now, this area was dependent, certainly through the late 80s, on aerospace. You have a book coming out next year called Blue Sky Architecture.
Blue Sky Metropolis, about the aerospace, yeah.
And I saw a piece that you wrote recently for KCET sort of lamenting the fall of a period where you could graduate from high school, get a job at McDonnell Douglas, have good benefits and a decent salary and raise your kids, and they'd go play at Hartwell Park and everyone would win. That period is over, and yet the economy isn't devastated. What is your take on how things have evolved from there, and are we nostalgic for a time that was as good as it seems in the rearview mirror, let's say?
Well, I am not a nostalgist, and I'm not nostalgic for the past, but indeed a realist. Many forces combined at the end of the Second World War to situate an immense economy of aerospace production in Southern California. One of the centers of that was the Douglas Aircraft Plant, just hardly more than 3 miles from where we're sitting right now. And that plant at that time, using the technologies available then, employed 50, 60,000 men, mostly men, in the workforce. Well, that represented one out of every 10 jobs in Lakewood for years and years and years. Douglas is gone. Boeing took over the company some years ago. Boeing is nearly gone. There's virtually no production left at the old Douglas plant except some assembly for the C-17 military transport plane.
Which is the last aircraft being built in Southern California,
It'll be the very last major aircraft built in Southern California. Aerospace continues. Defense-related manufacturing, high-tech elements of the aerospace environment will continue, but we don't make planes in Southern California anymore. We don't make planes at the doorstep of Lakewood any longer. And that has had enormous impacts on jobs and lifestyles in the region.
A lot of people received your book, Holy Land, in the mid-90s as a kind of defense of suburbia, or a defense of the idea that suburbia is a lot less cookie cutter than most people realize, even though there was three models of homes.
Well, there were more than that.
But basically, yeah. Three bedroom, two bathroom, we both could draw it on the wall right here. Now that Holy Land has been kind of received, and you yourself have kind of gone into the graduation of letters and have a national reputation, certainly you see the cultural forces which are still kind of against suburbia. How do you kind of square, or how do you retake that pulse in the year 2011? Do you still find suburbia interesting? Are you becoming more of a pusher of urbanite, kind of new urbanism because of it?
Let me just say that I'm a partisan of suburban places. I see in them the values that have been incorporated in my life. I see in them the values that have been incorporated in the lives of tens of thousands of people in Southern California, in Lakewood specifically. On the other hand, I also understand the uniqueness of urban development in Southern California in the LA area. Lakewood is not really a suburb anymore. It's a particular kind of urban place that looks suburban superficially, but which is netted fully into an urban fabric.
California has always been an optimistic place. People come here, last decade, not coming here as much. It's the first time, I think, in our history where population growth was the same as it was countrywide. Is it looking around at the political culture, at the fiscal crisis, and just the population growth numbers, is something changing kind of irrevocably, and is optimism going out the window with that?
I hope optimism isn't. California, Southern California, was a great attractor in the period from 1945 onward because here was located industries that grew every decade, and now those industries are gone. How do we replace that? What makes Southern California a great attractor still? Well, the weather didn't go away. The beaches didn't go away. The feeling people have about Southern California didn't go away. But I agree with you that a lot of the optimism has drained out of everyday life for working class people in Southern California. And we need to find ways in which that optimism can be restored.
Well, here's hoping that the renewal happens sometime soon. Thank you very much, DJ Waldie. For Reason TV, I am Matt Welch.